Hi, welcome to swarsaptaka.com. In audio editing, mixing, tips and tutorials, this is Audacity Tutorial Part 1 in Beginner Series. Audacity is a freeware audio recording, editing, mixing software for Windows, Mac and Linux. In this part, we will download Audacity and install it to our computers and do the basic setup and understand its interface. Audacity can be downloaded from audacity.sourceforge.net, and as I told you earlier, Audacity is a freeware, open source, cross-platform software. That means it can run on Windows, Mac, Linux and many other operating systems without any problem. Well, I am on Mac, so I will download this version, but in case you are on different operating system, you will click all Audacity downloads here and you will be taken to a page where other versions are available. Choose the correct one for your operating system and it's a small download. Within minutes, this will be downloaded to your system. After downloads, the installation is pretty simple. You just run the file which you downloaded and follow the instruction on the screen. In case you are on Windows, it will be installing in the program files. In case you are on Mac, it will install in application folder and so on. So I installed it, so I will run it. In the first run, Audacity will scan all the third-party plugin already installed on your system like audio units and VST. If you don't know what VST is, VST plugins are effect and instrument plugins which can be used in these type of softwares like Audacity, Cubase and Reaper. And this is very nice because it means that you will be able to use external software effect plugins to your audio material inside Audacity. This is the first help window which Audacity gives you, some help and forum links. I will strongly recommend you visit these links if you want to know Audacity better, because these are the places where you will get a lot of help. Right now I will check this so it does not come again, and I will make it full screen so you see things better. As you can see, there is an empty area in the middle which is your work area. You will see wave peak files, tracks and other controls in this area. I will import an audio file in Audacity that will explain things better, I guess. Whenever you import an audio file in Audacity, this will give you this window which says make a copy of the file before editing, save her. I will recommend that you keep it this way, because this way your original file on the hard disk remains untouched and Audacity creates a copy in the temporary folder and does all the editing and processing into that file. So check don't want again and always use my choice above. Click OK. And you see the imported audio's waveform. On the top left, you see some transport buttons: pause, play, stop, go to start, go to end, and record button. There are some tools. We will discuss these on our next videos. Here it will show output levels and input levels. And I'll take you to some playback adjustment features of the Audacity here. And here at the top, there is an output volume adjustment. It will adjust your speaker or headphone volume, whatever you are listening to. And on the right side of it, you can see there is an input adjustment, which will adjust your input volume or mic volume. On the left side, I would like you to pay attention to the driver choices. Right now, I'm using Core Audio, which is my built-in system driver. But you may have different choices in there, like Direct Sound, WDM, ASIO. So you should choose your driver appropriately what your system is using at the moment. Otherwise, probably will not get to hear any sound out of Audacity. And if that is the case, try different options available in there. The next important things to point at the project sample rate at the bottom left, which says 44100 at the moment. And this sample rate works pretty well in most situations. And in case you don't set the project sample rate, then the first file you import inside the Audacity will set the project sample rate. And in case you want to change the sample rate, you can change it from here, from 8000 to 96000. For example, 48,000 works well with video in case you're working with video a lot. But I will definitely recommend you stick to 44100 in case you don't know what you're doing at the moment. Another feature on the top right corner is a playback speed rate, which means you can play your song slower or faster than the normal, which is 1 means a normal speed, and if I make it 0.5, which means half speed, 0.5, and I hit play. Stop. This can be useful when you want to listen something detailed in slower speed. And you can also double the number for faster playback, double the speed, and make around 2 and hit play. Stop. But remember one thing, in Audacity, this playback speed feature is only for audition purposes. So it does not change your process, your file in any way. So your resulting file will playback in normal speed. In case you want to process it that way, then you have to use some time stretch and plugins. So I will change it back to 1, which is my actual speed, and hit play to check. Stop. Finally, in this part, I'll take you quickly through the preferences dialog. Devices. This is exactly the same thing, but we already adjusted in the first main window, so we don't have to do it again. Playback. Length of preview 6 seconds. Which means Audacity does not have real-time effect. So whenever we want to apply an effect, 6-second preview will be given. In case you want to have longer previews or audition, you can increase it here. Recording. Overdub option is checked by default, but in case it is not, please check it, because this way Audacity works like a multi-track, means you can listen other tracks while you record your vocals. Audio to buffer is set to 100 milliseconds here, which means you're on a slower system, not using a low latency sound card. Keeping this value higher will be safe. But with faster system and good sound card, you can lower this value to have lower latency. I will adjust it to 15 milliseconds and latency correction to minus 16 milliseconds should be fine here. With better sound cards, you can lower it further for faster response and lower latency. In quality tab, there are two things to look for: default sample rate and default sample format. Default sample rate we already discussed, and default sample format is basically bit rate, 16, 24 and 32 bits. I prefer 24 bit normally. In the preferences dialog, I would like to mention one more thing, that is libraries. You need to have two libraries, basically two files you need to download and install. If you work with MP3, you need to have MP3 lame encoder.dll or library. In case you click on the download dialog, so it will take you to the download page. And on this page, you choose the correct version of lame encoder for your computer and install it. Another library which it shows here, that is FFmpeg library. I already installed, so it's showing me the version number. But in case you did not, you click on the download button similarly and it will take you to the download page and install it. Sometimes Audacity cannot locate even after installing. In that case, you click on the locate button and direct to the correct folder. So Audacity will find it and start showing it up. Lame here, and yes, now it is showing me lame encoder version here, and that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching, and you are ready to go to Audacity tutorial part 2. See you in the next video.